Hello friends, in this lecture we will understand the concept of CSS overflow. Now in this document we have a div of container. Inside that we have another div with an ID of 1, and here it's mentioned that its width is 300 pixel and also the height is 300 pixel. Now let's add some content here. For this, let me go to lipsum.com and let's generate 5 paragraphs. Here it is. Now let's copy everything, press Ctrl C and come here, paste it, and let's save it. Now come to our page and hit refresh. Here it is. So what it is happening? So overflow is currently visible. Now let's come here and mention overflow visible. Let's save it. Come here, hit refresh. You can see nothing got changed because it is default. Now let's change to hidden. Let's save it. Come here, hit refresh. Now you can't see anything which is outside this 300 by 300 container. So now overflow is hidden. Now let's change this overflow to scroll. Let's save it. Come here, hit refresh. Now see, it's 300 by 300 only, and all those extra contents are here. You can scroll it to take a look. Now let's change it to auto. Let's save it. Come here, hit refresh. You will see it's scrolling only. So auto is kind of same as scroll. So what are the 4 values that we have seen? The first one is visible, which is default. Next we have seen hidden, where the content is hidden. I mean extra contents got hidden. I mean the overlapping contents got hidden. Then we have seen overflow scroll, where you can see all the contents, but you need to scroll to see those. And another we have seen, that is auto, which is similar to scroll only. So in this lecture we have seen how we can use overflow and where we can use it. So that's it friends. See you in the next lecture. Till then, have fun. Take care.